I see you have been working for NABARD, huh?
Sir, I resigned from NABARD.
You resigned?
In August 2018.
You said it was a permanent job?
Yes, sir, I resigned because I was selected in Bihar Administrative Service.
Oh, so now we are with Bihar Administrative Service?
Yes, sir, I joined in January 2019. And currently I am undergoing training.
And what is the what appointment will follow after that?
Sir,
first, what is the first appointment?
Deputy Collector, sir.
Deputy Collector?
Yes.
Oh, achha, 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 achha. So, tell me, anyway, you were with NABARD, no?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, what is the, how is, you know, NABARD was supposed to be flagship of government, you know, but what is the status of NABARD now, and you, the very fact you left? What, how many employees NABARD has?
Sir, NABARD has 4,000 employees, including from officers to PO.
And does NABARD follow the minimum wages formula? What is the minimum wages now? Do they follow the central government scale or?
Sir, NABARD's salary is higher than central government employees.
Achha, higher?
Yes, sir. Much higher than central government.
Much higher. Now, you know, you would have been saying there is a lot of reports have been coming out about minimum wages.
Yes, sir.
What sort of wage we are talking about now? What is the minimum wage in Bihar? You have any idea what is the minimum wage in Bihar now?
Sir, it is around 256 rupees per day.
Per day. And if this report is implemented, then how much it will go to? If this report is implemented, you know, you have seen the report. Today also it has been coming out for Gundas. The central government has appointed a panel for this thing. And if this report is implemented, then how much it will go up?
Sir, I do not know the exact figure, but it is something around 325 rupees per day.
Or maybe 350 or something
yes.
like that.
Okay.
So tell me, you have joined the Bihar, and you know, some matters of Bihar have been handed over to CBI.
Yes, sir. Sir, there are two matters under CBI. One is treason, treasury scam case, and the second one is regarding harassment of child in shelter homes.
Tell me this, you know, treason. Tell me, it's a very interesting case, no?
Yes, sir.
What exactly happened in that case?
Sir, in that case, the employees of the collectorate, the treasury officer, the employees of treasury and the banks collaborated and they forged the signature of district collectorate and they used to withdraw money without the sanction of district
collectorate. It's an old case.
Yes, sir.
And what has happened? I think it has been going on for quite some time.
Yes, sir.
So what has come out of this? What is happening? Where is it now?
Sir, it is right now, sir, the government suspended one additional district magistrate in this case and the inquiry is still pursuing and the final judgment has not been given yet.
Tell me, your subject was geography, right?
Yes, sir.
You have heard the, what is called, Straits of Malacca?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, what is the significance of Straits of Malacca, where it is located? What is the great significance of Straits of
Malacca? Sir, Strait of Malacca is located near Singapore. It is a choke point because all the trade from West Asia to East Asia, the oil from Gulf to China or Japan passes through this strait. So once it is blocked, the energy demand of Japan, China or other Asian countries will be blocked. So it is of great significance to Chinese.
Tell me, what is the strategic significance of Indo-Pacific? You know what is the Indo-Pacific region?
Yes, sir.
And what is the strategic significance of? And you know, it has been in the news quite a bit, specifically the Pacific Ocean has been in news for some time. So what is the significance of Indo-Pacific region for India?
Sir, the significance of Indo-Pacific is that it includes the Gulf countries which meets our oil demands. Apart from that,
Indo-Pacific region includes Gulf countries? Or even go ahead.
And sir, and I'm not aware about the strategic importance of Pacific Ocean for India.
But in general, would you like to comment? There have been some hot issues in the Pacific Ocean.
Sir, the one important issue is the problem of Chinese aggression in Pacific Ocean, in South China Sea, where Chinese claim the South China Sea, and which is in conflict with other countries like Japan, Vietnam, and Philippines. So
what is the India's view in this matter?
Sir, India's view is in alignment to United Nations Convention on Laws of the Sea, and in India.
Tell us something about the law of the seas. Tell us something about the law of the seas.
Sir,
what is the, you know, law of the seas defines the territorial water.
Yes, sir. Contiguous water.
Contiguous zone.
Contiguous zone, exclusive economic zone, and high seas.
High seas. Tell me, what is the, how much is the territorial sea now?
Sir, territorial sea is 12 nautical miles from the baseline.
And what about the
contiguous zone? Is 24 nautical miles from the baseline.
And the economic zone?
Sir, 200 nautical miles from baseline.
Tell me something about the International Seabed Authority and where it is located. You have heard of the Seabed Authority?
Yes, sir, I have heard it.
What is the prime role of the Seabed Authority?
Sir, it deals with the natural resources within the seabed.
Its headquarters are located in Caribbean.
Thank you, sir.
Now, tell me the significance of Caribbean to India.
Sir,
you know about Caribbean?
Yes.
Do you know Caribbean Sea?
Yes, sir. It is near Gulf of Mexico, adjoining to United States of America.
You have any idea what is the size of the Caribbean Sea and the countries bordering it?
Sir, the countries are West Indies.
Is there any country like West Indies? Have you heard of any country with the name of West Indies?
Sorry, sir, West Indies includes many.
Yeah, it's not West Indies. West Indies is the region.
Yes, sir.
West of Indies.
Sorry, sir.
These are called Caribbean countries.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
And you have heard the word CARICOM?
CARICOM, sir, I have heard, but I cannot recall.
It's called Caribbean.
Sir, it is about trade within, I think.
It is a Caribbean community. It is very important for India because it has 15 members. And you know, they each have a voting right.
Yes, sir.
In the UN.
Yeah,
and also there is a sizable Indian community in that region, like, you know, Guyana, Trinidad and Tobago, Suriname, Jamaica.
Yes.
So as a student of geology, tell me what, if you think of the Caribbean Sea, what is the one common point between India and the Caribbean Sea? What is the area of the Caribbean Sea?
Sir, I do not know about the exact area of the sea.
It's almost same as India. It's Thank about you, 2.5 million square kilometers.
Abhi Pacific Ocean ki baat kar rahe the.
Yes.
What is the significance of Pacific Ocean for Indian monsoons?
Sir, Indian the El Nino phenomena, which affects Indian monsoon, has origin in Pacific Ocean. It depends upon the low pressure at Port Darwin in Australia and high pressure at Port Tahiti in Pacific Ocean. So once these low pressure and high pressure are in normal state, the Indian territory gets good monsoon. But when this low pressure and high pressure reverses, the monsoon declines in India. It affects the monsoon rainfall.
Now, there's La Nino and El Nino.
Yes, sir.
How are they determined?
Sir, they are determined through sea surface temperature, atmospheric circulation of the winds.
So when would we have La Nino and when would we have?
Sir, when the Port Darwin, which is near Australia, has low atmospheric pressure, then it is the when there is low pressure at Tahiti, which is in eastern Pacific Ocean, then there is a condition of El Nino in India, as it is opposite of worker circulation, which is the normal state. But but after El Nino, there is a phenomenon of La Nina, when there is excess, when the normal state comes back, but with a greater intensity, under which there is a low pressure at Port Darwin in Australia, and there is high pressure at Port Tahiti.
You are working in Bihar.
Yes,
sir. And Bihar had reservation policy from within the for the OBCs and within the OBCs for most backwards and others within that 27%.
Yes.
Now the government of India has introduced another 10% for general category.
Yes, sir.
How do you think this would affect the dynamics of various communities?
Sir, the reservation for economically weaker section, that is 10%, is a separate segment. Mm-hmm. That will not affect the reservation policy currently provided in Bihar or in any state, sir. It will benefit the backward, the weaker section within general category students. It is in excess to the 49.5% limit of reservation.
You see, that brings me to the question that reservation per
yes.
se has been, was envisaged only for 10 years initially
yes.
by Pandit Nehru, and then it has been extended year after every decade, and even now we have starting from 22%, now we have 50%.
Yes.
And yet the benefits of this reservation have not reached the most
yes, sir.
Downtrodden. That is why we have the most backward classes.
Yes.
What you think are the possible reasons for this shielding of the downward people from getting the benefits of reservation?
Sir, one of the factor is that reservation benefit is currently being availed by only a few elite within a particular community, while the poor people within a community do not get the benefit. So there is a need for
why they don't get it. That's the, and if we have to make a provision, what according to you would be a collector, what provisions you would make to make sure that these provisions and these benefits reach the most.
Sir, there can be introduction of sub-reservation, sub-caste based reservation. Like within SC, there can be few castes which can be excluded, who have reached good economic and social status. And apart from that, sir, people can also be excluded based upon their educational background, like who have lived in cities, got education in public school and have good educational opportunities, they can be excluded, while those who have lived in rural areas, they can only be provided benefits, sir.
And what if somebody has already got the benefit and reached a particular level?
So sir, there can be also limitation on the number of times which one can get benefit of reservation. Like if one person has taken reservation benefit for one time or two times, they can be eliminated from the reservation criteria.
Gaurav,
yes sir.
Can you give some light about digital divide in India, both nationally and regionally?
Have you heard this name, digital divide?
Digital divide.
Yes, sir. Digital divide means that those who have the access to digital technology like internet and mobile devices or computer, and they are digitally literate and have all the digital facilities, while people in rural areas who are excluded from the benefits of digital media.
Are they? In fact, recently a report said that UPI is the largest digital payment service across the globe. Are you aware about it?
Sorry, sir. I'm not aware about it.
Are you aware about UPI?
Yes, sir. Unified Payment Interface.
Have you any idea about how it happens? What is the transaction level?
No, sir.
So when it comes to digital literacy,
yes, sir.
Government has been doing a lot of initiatives.
Yes, sir.
Apart from that, a lot of companies and corporates have been made, lot of Wi-Fi's have been given across.
Yes.
Patna being one of the stations where a case study of Wi-Fi was considered.
Yes.
Can you tell me that how misutilization of digital access has created more problems than a solution, which we talk about benefits of digital, and what will you do as an administrator?
Sir, the misutilization of digital media is in spreading fake news, rumors, which lead to lynching of people or emergence of riot in an area, as the information which is circulated on digital media are not verified, and it tries to evoke emotion within the people and creates public disorder. And sir, as a district collector, I would ask the superintendent of police to set up a dedicated digital media cell within the district, which will monitor the information which is being circulated over Facebook or WhatsApp, and immediately when there is a circulation of fake news, they can be countered immediately by providing the true facts of the cases.
Are you aware about cyber act, cyber laws?
Yes, sir. I'm aware about Information Technology Act 2000 and Cyber Security Policy 2013.
And cyber police stations?
Yes, sir. Some states have your cyber police stations, like
Maharashtra. Have you read through any impact of those cyber police stations in the demography where they operate, especially leading to such social media cases? Is they an add-on resource or they are useful?
Sir, cyber police station have been set up at Mumbai and Pune. I know about this, and the reports have come that they have.
You mentioned that you are right now staying at Noida.
Right now, I'm staying at my father's place at Mayur Vihar. Phase one.
I saw some Noida also, Gautam Buddh Nagar district.
And that is my father's office, Union Bank of India, Noida.
One, two, three. So UP 100 scheme, are you aware about UP 100 scheme?
No, sir. Sorry, sir.
You are not aware. Can you tell me one thing, that high-end sports in India has not been able to take on?
Yes.
And one of your passion is Formula One.
Yes.
How sports tourism can develop India? Only 5 points I need in high-end sports.
Sir, high-end sports are global market. Like in USA, Australia and other developed countries. So if those are developed, that will lead to increase in the tourist, which will help India in earning foreign exchange. Apart from that, it will generate employment. It will be a boost to the GDP of the country. Apart from that, sir, it will create a high-end sports culture within India, and players or sports person would like to participate in that event.
But knowing it also, last 5 years, you see there is no Formula One in India.
Yes, sir.
What is your thought?
Sir, about the reason of not having.
Yeah.
Sir, the reason is that the taxation issue between Uttar Pradesh government and the Federation of International Automobile, where Uttar Pradesh government wants to charge Formula One, wants to charge in tax on the Formula One as a entertainment, while FIA, Federation International Automobile, wants that Uttar Pradesh government should charge it as a sports. And apart from that, the poor balance sheet of JP Group, who is the owner of the track. And the third reason is lack of interest among Indian audience.
But that means it is not going to encourage the tourism, sports tourism, if there is lack of.
Sir, apart from organizing the event, there is a need for marketing on social media. During the time 2011 to 2014, the social media was not that much prevalent in India. In the current days, if it comes back to India, I think it will have much bigger impact in India.
Thank you.
You're from Delhi University?
Yes.
Which college in Delhi University became the first to have a monumental national flag?
Sir, Hansraj College.
It's your
yes,
alma mater. Can you tell us something about that college? Like, when was it established and what was the contribution of the gentleman after whom it is named?
Sir, Hansraj College was established in 1948 and it is named after Lala Hansraj, who is the founder of Dayanand Agglo Vedic school system in India. He was one of the follower of Ari Samaj and Dayanand Saraswati.
Yes. Some notable alumni from your college?
Sir, Sri Naveen Jindal, Sri Kiran Rijiju, who is Honorable State of Home Affairs, and Sir Sri Ajay Makan. Apart from that, sir, in Bollywood, Shah Rukh Khan.
Very prestigious college you're from.
Thank you, sir.
Bihar has implemented prohibition.
Yes, sir.
Right, so do you think it has like actually made a difference on the ground?
Yes, sir. In the ground there has been improvement. As per the National Crime Record Bureau data, there has been decline in crime rate within the state. And the women in the state are very much happy, as the domestic violence has reduced due to the prohibition effect. Apart from that, people used to spend the money, whatever the meager amount money they used to earn on the alcohol. But now they are using it over other, like education of the child, good nutrition.
So do you think we should impose prohibition at a national level?
Sir, at national level, I think it should not be introduced, because in Bihar it was required because of the poor literacy and awareness. But other states like South Indian states are advanced and have better education facilities. They know about what is right and what is not right. But in Bihar that was lacking, sir. So it was need of the hour.
Okay. What can be done to, you know, get Bihar out of the Bimaru states?
Sir, for that Bihar needs to train the human resources, as 60% of the population is below 30 years of age. So it has huge human resource. If that is skilled properly, then that can create multiplier effect within the state itself. And sir, Bihar has very good land resources, and sir, that can be utilized to its potential by introducing new technologies and developing food processing industries. So Bihar can become a hub of agro-based industries in the country.
The economic growth rate of Bihar has actually picked up significantly.
Yes, sir. It was highest this year at 11.3% in the country.
So, and you know, Bihar has also seen a lot of mandal-based politics, right? Rise of the OBCs through the 90s and so on. Still, it is quite regarded as one of the most backward when it comes to socio-economic indicators.
Yes.
What are the reasons for that?
Sir, one of the reasons is that huge population of the state, and which due to his government doesn't have enough resource to meet the requirement of everyone in the state. So this is one of the major reasons, major reason of poor educational or health facilities. Because the resources are very thinly distributed over the population.
Okay. Bihar has also implemented reservation for women at Panchayati Raj level up to, I think, 50%?
Yes, sir, it is 50% in Bihar.
So do you think we should have that, you know, reservation for women in the parliament?
Yes, sir. Women should get reservation in the parliament, as they constitute 50% of the population, but right now they are only 11% within the parliament. So if they are represented in parliament, then women issues can get more attention, which is right now lacking in the country.
And lastly, just share with us, what is the motto of Hansraj College?
Sir, the motto of Hansraj College is dedicated, Tamso Ma Jyotirgamya, from darkness.
Means?
Yes. From darkness, lead me to light.
Thank you.
ये दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी का है हंसराज का है
दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी का सर डेडिकेटेड टू ट्रूथ है हंसराज का तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय
ओके कैन यू गिव अस अ ब्रीफ ओवरव्यू ऑफ माइक्रो फाइनेंस सेक्टर इन इंडिया
सर माइक्रो फाइनेंस सेक्टर इन इंडिया इज डन विद द हेल्प ऑफ सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप and under which NABARD is one of the prominent players. NABARD played an important role in formation of 87 lakh self-help groups within the country. it has also played role in the credit linkage of the self-help group. So microfinance is basically, sir, formation of SHG and linkage into the bank and then availing the credit from the banks.
Okay. And what is the difference between SHG and JLG?
Sir, SHG is self-help group, whereas JLG is joint liability group.
Yeah. What is the exact difference?
Sir, in SHG, the group
you have worked on these reports for quite a few years.
So, sir, actually I was not dealing with this section in the ward. Sir, okay. SHG is basically a larger group of people. From 10 to 20 people forms the SHG, while the joint liability group is only 4 to 10 member. And joint liability group is basically a credit oriented group, where the groups are formed and they avail credit. But SHG is mainly a selling based group formation.
Okay, our former RBI governor, Mr. Raghuram Rajan, in his estimate, in his note to Estimates Committee of the Parliament, warned that next financial crisis will be because of NPAs.
Yes, sir.
What is your opinion about that?
Sir, as per the recent report, the NPA has been declining, as it declined from 11.5% to 10.8% in the recent report. And apart from that, government has taken multiple steps for tackling the NPA issues, like formation of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India, which has helped in reducing NPA. And apart from that, the 4 R's of the Reserve Bank, the government.
Mr. Rajan is not writing his assessment.
Sir, he was right, but government is working in direction of reducing the NPAs.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Have a good luck.